हेलो एवरीवन, लास्ट टाइम वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद द पैकिंग ऑफ पार्टिकल्स इन क्रिस्टल लैटिस। वी हैव कंप्लीटेड वन डायमेंशनल एज वेल एज टू डायमेंशनल पैकिंग। सो वी नो द कोऑर्डिनेशन नंबर ऑफ वन डायमेंशन, दैट इज टू। एंड फॉर टू डायमेंशनल देयर वर टू थिंग्स, स्क्वायर क्लोज पैकिंग एंड हेक्सागोनल क्लोज पैकिंग। टुडे वी विल बी लर्निंग थ्री डायमेंशन इन विच वी विल बी यूजिंग टू डायमेंशनल स्क्वायर पैकिंग एज वेल एज हेक्सागोनल क्लोज पैकिंग विद दिस ओनली। सी, वेन वी स्टार्टेड विद टू डायमेंशन वी बी यूजिंग वन डायमेंशन। सिमिलरली वेन वील बी स्टार्टिंग विद थ्री डायमेंशनल वी हैव टू टेक दिस एज अ बेसिस नाउ। ओके, एंड वन थिंग आई जस्ट फॉरगॉट लास्ट टाइम टू टेल यू। सी हियर, ट्रायंगुलर वॉइड्स आर फॉर्म्ड of two shapes, one showing apex at the top and the other one showing apex at the bottom. So two kinds of triangular voids are formed over here. So let's start with three dimensional close pack structure today. So close packing in three dimension, so that means, as I told you before, there will be what, x, y as well as z axis. That means we have to imagine a little bit when we are learning this 3D structures. Please understand, you have to imagine a little bit, because in paper we cannot show a 3D structure. Okay, so to start with, now this three dimensional packing, as I said, will be formed by using two dimensional. So two dimensional square packed, when it is used, it can be done only in one way. What is that? Therefore, it will lead to simple cubic lattice. Okay, we'll learn in detail. First, we'll just learn the types. So, three-dimensional, there are two types. Two-dimensional square close-packed layers, when arranged together, we'll get a simple cubic structure. Then is two-dimensional hexagonal close-packed structures. When it is arranged together, it can be arranged in two ways. So, therefore, they will lead to what? Two structure, hexagonal close pack structure, or it is also called as and face centered cubic structure. Okay, it is FCC or CCP. CCP is one and the same thing over here. Hopefully till here it is understood. Square close pack structure, that means this thing, whenever it is repeated, will lead to simple cubic structure. Only one thing is there, nothing else. If this structure is taken, it can be done in two ways. Okay, one will lead to HCP structure, other one will lead to FCC or CCP structure. We learn that. Okay, fine. So next is stocking of square close pack structures. Okay, stocking, that means arranging square close pack structure. You know that when we have made square close pack structure, all the spheres, that means one dimensional spheres, were kept one above the other. Similar way, here the second layer, that means this layer is used, this many of the layers, like 2, 3, it depends upon how much big I want the crystal. Like that, if I take for example 10 things are kept in such a manner that it is one, the first layer will be exactly above the second layer, so that it will be aligned horizontally as well as vertically. As a result, this kind of, since everything is aligned, means one above the other is kept. So if I refer the first layer as A, the second layer will be also A, and all the rest of the layers will be AA type. So therefore, it is also called as AA type of crystal. Okay, now this type of crystal results in simple cubic structure, and the unit cell, you know that smallest repeating pattern in a crystalline solid is said to be the unit cell. The unit cell is primitive cubic unit cell. What do you mean by primitive cubic unit cell? Hopefully you know, the number of particles in that is taken, the total number of particles in that thing is taken as 1, and the particles are only at the corners. That is why we have learned everything. That's why I'm just referring it, as I cannot say in all the lecture, I cannot repeat the same thing. We have dealt that thing in the earlier classes. Okay. So, now as a result, you, if you understood this thing, it will be easier for you to tell me what is coordination number. Now, what will be the coordination number? Now, when we have taken this thing in one plane, it was 4. Okay. Now, one layer kept above as well as one layer kept below. So, in one plane, it will be 4 plus 1 down and 1 above, because one sphere will come exactly above this thing and one sphere will come exactly below that thing. Okay, as a result, the total number of coordination number over here will be nothing but 6. And the crystal formed will be of polonium. Okay, PO. This is the only example for this kind of crystal. Hope till here it is completed. Okay, the next thing. Now, this thing is covered over here. Okay, square closed pack structure leads to one way, that is simple cubic lattice, done. Now, the next thing, we are taking hexagonal closed pack structure. That means we are taking this structure. That means where we have kept in the depression. The second layer is kept in such a manner that it covers the depression of the first layer. That sheet is taken. Okay, now this sheet, this one sheet, first I'll be keeping one more sheet above that thing. That can be done in this manner. Okay, so stocking of two hexagonal closed pack structures. Okay, that is the first one. That means only two sheets I have taken over here. Now, for example, the one which I have drawn in pencil is the first layer, and the one which I have drawn in pen is a second layer. Okay, hope you'll understand. You have to imagine over here. Okay, so this, we see the layer we have kept in the depression over here. Okay, this will lead to, if this is called as A, this will be called as B layer. So that means I have kept the second layer such a manner that it will cover this triangular voids. Triangular voids over there. Okay, now as a result, when we keep the second layer, there leads to 3 voids. Okay, there are 3 voids. These two are same, called as tetrahedral voids. This is called as tetrahedral voids, and this one is called as octahedral void. And this is called as octahedral void. Now, what do you mean by tetrahedral void and octahedral void? Now, just see in this structure. Can you the first layer, if 3 circles are there and one sphere exactly comes above the triangular void, what happens? There leads a void in the first layer. Okay, as a result, that means it is formed of 4 spheres, therefore it is referred to as tetrahedral void. See, even one more we can see over here. Here, it is in the reverse manner. That means, one sphere from the first layer and 3 spheres from the second layer leads to a void in a second layer. Leads to the void in the second layer. So, this thing is said to be tetrahedral void since it is made up of 4 spheres. Now, there are one more void which is created, which is nothing but this one. That means 3 triangles in the first layer and 3 spheres in the first layer and 3 spheres in the second layer leads to octahedral void. Okay. So, by keeping this as a basis, now I am going to arrange one more hexagonal closed packed structure, which will help me to understand the difference between HCP and CCP structure. Hopefully till here it is clear. You have to learn this thing. You have to imagine a little bit. You just have to remember. Here we are taking hexagonal closed pack structure. 2 layers are kept, which leads to tetrahedral void and octahedral void. The third layer will be kept either in tetrahedral void or in the octahedral void. Okay. So now, when placing third hexagonal closed pack layers. Now, that is done by covering tetrahedral voids or by covering octahedral voids. Now, When it is done by covering tetrahedral voids there, it will lead to ABAB type of structure. It will lead to ABAB type of structure. It will lead to ABAB type of structure. Now, by the name itself, you will understand that the first and the third layer will be exactly similar. That means in alignment, and the second and fourth layer will be in alignment. Okay. And for this thing, the example over here will be nothing but what? Magnesium. Example will be magnesium and zinc. Magnesium and zinc. And this structure will lead to HCP structure, hexagonal close packed structure. This will lead to hexagonal close packed structure. Okay. Now, by covering octahedral voids, when we cover the octahedral voids, this will lead to ABC type of structure. Now, what do you mean by ABC type of structure? Here, the third layer which is kept will be entirely different than the first and the second layer. Therefore, this will lead to FCC or CCP structure, face centered cubic structure, or close pack cubic pack structure. And the example over here is nothing but what? Copper or Ag. Ag is nothing but silver over here. Okay. So, till here hopefully it is completed. I'll just show you the picture which is there in the textbook. Okay. So, this was our AA type of structure, which was only because of the simple cubic structure. We have taken square close pack structure and arranged. So, as a result, AA layer is formed. Now, over here, ABAB type of hexagonal close pack is formed. That means we have taken a hexagonal close pack structure in two dimensional and arranged. This is only, I have taken two sheets. As a result, there will be tetrahedral voids as well as octahedral voids. Now, can you see here, this thing is referred to as the tetrahedral void, and the hole which is coming is nothing but our octahedral void, where three spheres are down and three spheres are up. 1 2 3 1 2 3. Okay, hopefully till here it is done. Now, placing the spheres in the third layer. Now, placing the spheres in the third layer will lead to two different arrangement. Okay, one when we are keeping it in tetrahedral void, and the other one when we are keeping it in octahedral void. This will give me this kind of structure. Okay, this one, 1, 6 are there, 3, then 6, then 3. Okay, now in such kind of structure, what will be the coordination number? The coordination number over here will be 12. The coordination number over here will be 12. Actually, in both the things, either it is HCP or CCP or FCC, the coordination number over here will be 12. See, 6 in the same plane, 3 up and 3 down leads to 12. Okay, so similar way, when octahedral 2, this thing is kept, it will lead to this kind of structure. Okay, similarly, it will be the same thing. If I am taking any one of a sphere, it will be what? 6 in the same plane and 3 up and 3 below. Okay, 3 up and 3 below, it will be there. It will go on repeating. As a result, here also it will be 12. Here also it will be 12. Okay, hopefully till here it is done. Now we'll just revise the coordination number in all these things. Okay, so coordination number in one dimensional. The coordination number in one dimensional was what? 2. 2 dimensional square packing, square pack structure. It was nothing but what? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, it was over here 4. In 2-dimensional hexagonal close pack structure, it was nothing but total 6. 3-dimensional square close pack structure, as I mentioned earlier, it will be nothing but what? 6, 4 in one plane, one above and one below. Okay, so again here it will be 6, and rest 2, it let that be HCP, CCP or FCC, everywhere it is 2. So please learn the coordination number in each one. Please do learn this thing in nicely, this table nicely. Okay, now the last one over here. The number of voids per atom in HCP and CCP structure. Now, if I say that the number of particles or the number of spheres which I have taken, is equal to n in number, okay, then number of tetrahedral void will be nothing but 2n, and number of octahedral void will be n. That means if I have taken 50 spheres, okay, like that, if I have taken 50 spheres, okay, and arranged properly, then this will lead to how many tetrahedral voids? Double the number. That means it will lead to 100. And how many number of octahedral void will be there? There will be 50 number. Okay, hopefully this thing is cleared. Okay, so next we have to learn the packing now. Packing efficiency. Okay, so we have to learn this packing efficiency of metal crystals in simple cubic lattice. Okay, now by seeing one dimensional, two dimensional and three dimensional, you might have understood that when it comes to three dimensional, if we compare square closed packed structure or HCP or FCC structure, the FCC structure or HCP structure is said to be efficient in packing. That means more it is, by the look itself we can just say that is efficiently packed. That means how can we say that it is efficiently packed? The voids created there will be less. That means less number of vacant space will be left over in the crystal. Then only we can say that we have packed the crystals efficiently. Okay, fine. So now we have to mathematically see what is the packing efficiency in simple cubic structure. You have to learn only three things. You are learning simple cubic lattice, body centered and face centered structure. Just a revision for this thing. The number of particles which was there in simple cubic structure is 1. The number of particles in BCC structure, that is body centered cubic structure, is 2. And the number of particles in FCC structure is 4. So let's start with this thing now. Okay, so there are 4 steps. If I will do this thing, you people should be able to do the other 2. Only first part, if I will tell you how to do it, the rest is the same in all the cases. So please understand, for this thing you have to first understand there are 4 steps in each one to calculate the packing efficiency. There are 4 steps. What are the steps? Step 1, radius of sphere or particle. Step 2, volume of sphere or particle. Step 3, total number of particles. And step 4, packing efficiency. Okay, now we'll just write down the formula of packing efficiency. I'll just refer it as PE. Packing efficiency is nothing but volume occupied by particle in unit cell upon total volume of unit cell multiplied by 100. Okay, so here we have to find out the percentage. Okay, fine. So the first one, just we'll start. So before starting, I'll just draw one figure, a simple cube. okay? So this is one cube. You know, in simple cubic lattice, the constituent particles are only at the corners. So for our reference, we just put a dot in the corners, but actually there is one sphere in that corner which will be shared by 8 such unit cells. We have learned that thing, okay? So therefore the number of particles leads to 1 there. So to understand, first always remember radius of sphere or particle is nothing but we have to find the relation between A and R. We have to actually find a relation between A and R. What is A over here? A is nothing but referred to as the edge length. A is nothing but the edge length, and R is nothing but the radius. Okay, hopefully this thing is clear. Okay, now you know the constant particle. So just imagine the first one, first square which you can see. Okay, here if I draw a sphere over here, okay, and actually it should be a bigger sphere, then only you will understand. Okay, so either I can draw two spheres over here, this is one sphere, and here one more sphere I can draw. Okay, it should be of equal size, so you can draw a little bit smaller. Okay, like that you can draw the spheres. Okay, now to understand here, this is nothing but equal to A. Everything is nothing but equal to A. Now this, in if this is a sphere, this much portion is nothing but small r, radius of a sphere. This is nothing but small r, radius of a sphere. So we can say that in this thing, what is the relation? A, this whole thing is nothing but, this whole thing is nothing but A. This A is equal to 2r. Okay, so I got a relation between A is equal to 2r. Now what is r will be equal to? R will be nothing but equal to A upon 2. So this relation I have to use in step 2. Now volume of sphere. Simple, you might have learnt in your earlier classes. What is that volume of sphere? So I'll just write on volume. It's nothing but equal to 4 upon 3 pi r cube. This is nothing but the volume of a sphere. Now I'll just substitute the value of r over here. So I will get what? 4 upon 3 pi. Instead of r, I'll substitute it as what? A upon 2 the whole cube. You can say from 1 if you want. Okay, now I have to just solve it. Okay, so I can say that after solving, I'll get 4 upon 3. This is nothing but 2 into 2 into 2. So 2, 2 to the 4, 4 and 4 get cancelled. So left is 3 to the 6. So 6 is left below. Up here it will be pi and a cube. Okay, so this is nothing but step 2. We got the answer for the volume. Now this is volume of one particle. Okay, now we know that total volume of particles will be what? Now in case of simple cube, the number of particle in one unit cell is equal to 1. Therefore I can say it will be same. Therefore volume occupied by particle in unit cell is equal to number of particles, that is n, multiplied by what is the volume there. Okay, so that is nothing but 1 into this thing remains pi a cube upon 6. Okay, so till here hopefully this is done. This is very simple. Now packing efficiency, I just have to now put the values there. Now I know that volume occupied by particle in unit cell, I'll get it from step 3. What is that? Pi a cube upon 6. Okay, now this thing is divided by total volume of unit cell. Total volume of unit cell is what? Nothing but a cube. So I have to know the volume of cube. Now volume of cube is nothing but length into length into length. That is, here edge length is nothing but A. So I can write it as A cube multiplied by 100. This A cube and A cube gets cancelled. I just have to now write down the value of this thing. This is nothing but 3.142 upon 6 into 100. After solving this, you'll get a value of 52.366. So we can write it as 52.37%. So this is nothing but my packing efficiency. Okay. Now, packing efficiency means what? This much space is occupied by the particle, this constant particle in the crystal. So the rest space is said to be vacant. So I can say that void volume is nothing but 100 minus 52.37. So that value will be nothing but approximately equal to what? 47.63%. Okay, this calculated, you'll get the value. Simple max is there, 100 minus whatever the value we have got over here, we just have to subtract that. Okay, fine. Hopefully till here it is done. Next class we'll be learning body centered and FCC, the packing efficiency in body centered and FCC crystal. Okay then. Thank you.